Good morning, everyone. Good morning. Welcome to the Restoration Church Ministries. Pastor Gerald Adams. We do not own any rights to any of the music playing in the background. Welcome, welcome, welcome. We do not own any rights to any of the music playing in the background. Sharon, God bless you. Good to see you this morning. Sister Karen, it was great spending time with you last week. God bless you. Good to see you. I know that I can make it. I know that I can stand. No matter what comes my way, my life is in His hands. God bless each and every one of you. Welcome to the Restoration Church Ministries. This is Pastor Gerald Adams. It is an honor, a privilege, and a pleasure to be with you on today. We will not belabor the hour. We will go in straight into God's Word so that you can get out and enjoy this beautiful day that God has given each and every one of us. Let us bow our heads in a word of prayer, and then we will go forth in our lesson today. If you have your Bibles, our lesson is going to come from one scripture. Good morning, Miss Lisa. God bless you this morning. It's going to come from 1 Corinthians, the 10th chapter, verse number 13. But let us bow our heads in a word of prayer as we do every time we come together so that we might invoke the presence of the Lord in this time. Father, we thank you for your goodness, your kindness, your mercy. We thank you, Lord Jesus Christ, for how good you have been to us. Thank you, O God, for taking us through this week. Thank you, O God, for even though we have faced trials and tribulations, O God, we thank you that you have been the constant in our lives. We thank you, God, that you have been faithful and you have blessed us as only you can. Father, we pray right now in the name of Jesus that you would bless the hearers of this word right now and those that will hear it later, God. We pray right now that something will be said, oh God, that would help them, oh God, in the name of Jesus Christ, that would strengthen their faith. We give you glory, honor, and praise for it, oh God. Hide me right now behind that cross, oh God, until this awesome task of proclaiming your word is done. Father, we pray in the name of Jesus Christ that your people will be edified. Oh God, that you would receive all glory and be glorified, and the demons of hell would be terrified. God, we pray in Jesus' name. Oh God, have your way today. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, and amen. Well, God bless each and every one of you again. Welcome to the Restoration Church Ministries. I'm Pastor Gerald Adams. We thank God for each and every one of you. We were actually in the Holy Convocation on last week. That's why we did not broadcast live. So we were with all of the sister churches. And so we thank God for each and every one of you being in, tuning in today. And we are not going to belabor the hour. We're going to go straight into God's word. 1 Corinthians 10th chapter, verse number 13. We just want to lift up one verse today so that we could go forward. And the word of the Lord reads on this wise: "There has no temptation taken you, but such as common to man. But God is faithful, who will not suffer you to be tempted above you are able, but will with the temptation also make a way to escape, that ye may be able to bear it." That ye may be able to bear it. That ye may be able to bear it. God bless you, Deacon Adams. Good to see you today. I want to speak to you from this one verse of scripture today about the ability to endure. The ability to endure. And we are going to be basically talking about temptation today and how you endure the things and situations of life that comes about to tempt you in life. God bless you, Brother Dale. Good to see you this morning. Good morning. I pray that you had a blessed birthday on this week. God bless you. Good to see you. And when we look at the word temptation, it's a noun and it's defined as a desire to do something, especially something wrong or unwise. That's how Webster defines it. It defines it again as a desire to do something, especially something wrong or unwise. Temptation is something we all face as people of God, as people in general. This is something that we all face as believers in Christ, no matter how long we have been in this world, no matter how long we have been living, how long we have been following Christ. Temptation is a part of life. Hallelujah. But as God's believers, as we believe in God, with every temptation, the word of God says God will provide a way of escape. And this is important to us. This should make us excited about what God is saying to us today, simply because if we were to know King Solomon and his wisdom, he once said in Ecclesiastes 1:9, he says, "There is nothing new under the sun." So again, the Bible tells us here that there is no temptation that have taken us, which is not common to man. Whatever temptations we face, whatever temptations we're facing, or we will face in the future. Hallelujah. Others have faced it before and they have endured, and so can we. One of the challenges of facing temptations is that we often feel as though we're the only ones struggling with our particular temptation or situation. We go through situations and time and things of life, praise the name of our God, and we get so caught up, hallelujah, in what we're going through, or the enemy, praise the name of our God, is whispering in our ear, hallelujah, and we come to the conclusion that we are, hallelujah, the only ones struggling, hallelujah, with our particular situation, hallelujah. We look around and then we begin to ask, when we start to struggle with this, we begin to ask, hallelujah, the question, why am I the only one, hallelujah, struggling with this thing? Praise the name of our God. And the truth be told, you're not the only one going through it. The next question that would come up after we ask the question, praise the name of our God, why am I the only one going through this? It feeds into, hallelujah, the enemy feeds it. It feeds you with the next question, which is then, what is wrong with me? Mm-hmm. Not only why am I the only one going through this, but what is wrong with me? The enemy wants you to believe, praise the name of our God, that there is something significant wrong with you because you are going through a situation, or you're going through, hallelujah, temptation. But I want to encourage everybody today, praise the name of our God, that there is a way out. The reality is that there is nothing wrong with us. There's nothing wrong with you. I want to speak specifically to you today. There is nothing wrong with you. You're facing what is common to us all. You are facing the very thing that each and every one of us, hallelujah, face in life. We all live this life and we all have the same, hallelujah, temptations. We have the same, hallelujah, some of us have the same desires. So there is nothing wrong with you. You are facing what is common to us all. That simply means everyone faces the same types of temptations. Praise the name of our God. There is no unique or extreme temptations that are impossible to overcome. If other people have managed to overcome it, to resist it, to move beyond it, praise the name of our God, and we can as well. God is wanting to encourage somebody today, hallelujah, that whatever you're struggling with today, hallelujah, you have endured it this long, hallelujah, but there's time is coming where, hallelujah, he's going to give you a way of escape. If we would simply just tell the truth and shame the devil as believers, the problem, hallelujah, sometimes is not the temptation itself, but when we face temptations, we are not looking for our escape route. Hear me again. I'm going to say that one more time. When we are facing temptations, a lot of time, if we would just tell the truth and shame the devil, it is not the temptation itself that is bothering us, but it is that we are not looking for our escape route. God has promised that he will give you a way of escape. But are we looking for our escape route? We are not really looking for God to help us. Hallelujah. We get so discouraged and we get so broken down in what is going on, the vicissitudes of life, the commonality of things going on around us. And so we stop and we don't even bother to look for God's help. We don't even look for the way that God has promised to give us for escape. Why is that, you say, Pastor Adams? Maybe, hallelujah, because we are, hallelujah, secretly enjoying, hallelujah, hallelujah, enjoying the sin or that secret sin that we have been enduring. Maybe, hallelujah, we would rather sit around and complain and just grumble about the situation and grumble and complain about God. Why do you say that, Pastor Adams? Because some of us, hallelujah, we like the attention of it all, if you will. I want to say that again, praise the name of our God. Some of us, we just like the attention of it all. So we decide that we're going to sit around instead of looking for where God, hallelujah, God has provided a way of escape. We sit around and complain, praise the name of our God. Hallelujah, we sit around, hallelujah, and grumble at the situation. But when we do so, praise the name of our God, we must understand that the thing that we are going through, hallelujah, is not common to is common to man. Why do you say that, Pastor Adam? The reason I say that is because we all have, hallelujah, the inclination, praise the name of our God, to grumble and complain. Why do you say that? Because it's common to man. We all complain. I'm not sitting up here throwing stones at you, hallelujah, not pointing a finger back at me. We all have the ability to complain about things that's happening in life. And that's a temptation from the enemy to complain about where you are in life. But it's common to man. So there is a constant temptation for us to do so. Hallelujah. But I want to encourage you today, although and this is just one thing, hallelujah, that I pulled out today about grumbling or complaining about the things that's going on in your life. But here in the word of God, God gives us, hallelujah, the assurance that there not only is a way of escape, hallelujah, but that he would provide it. Oh God. And if God provides the way of escape, then you know when you come out, you're coming out with the victory. Oh God, I give you glory. Hallelujah. We have to get beyond what we're going through. What are you talking about, Pastor Adam? I need to get beyond, hallelujah, the sickness that I'm dealing with. Praise the name of our God. I need to get beyond, hallelujah, not having enough and complaining about the bills that come in. Oh God, I give you glory. Hallelujah. When I stop complaining about the bills that come in, then God can be who he said he is. He owns the cattle upon a thousand hills, and it all belongs to him. And whatever you need, he will supply. I want to encourage somebody today. We can stop complaining. We can stop, hallelujah, grumbling about what's going on in our lives. Hallelujah. When we begin, hallelujah, to believe, truly believe Romans 8 and 28, that tells us that God works all things for our good according to his purpose. Then, hallelujah, we can stop complaining. Because when we complain, praise the name of our God, we are telling the sovereign God of heaven and earth, hallelujah, that he does not know what he is doing. When we complain and we grumble against God, we are telling God, Almighty God, you made a mistake. You just don't know what you're doing. But how many of you know that we serve a God that sees from a different perspective? We only can see what's in front of us. We can only see from what our two eyes are and our ability to see. But we have a God that sits high and has a different perspective. Nothing gets past him and nothing gets beyond him. God knows what's going on. He knows what we're feeling and he knows what we're going through. And so God sent me here to explain to you today. He told me to tell you, do not be fooled by the situation. He told me to tell you, don't, hallelujah, listen to the enemy that's in your ear. And some of our enemies are right in our home. We're telling our family members how much we believe in God for a breakthrough. But our family members are saying, hallelujah, that, hallelujah, you know that mama died of this disease. Our daddy suffered from that disease. But I came by to encourage you today that God can work out your situation. If he did it, hallelujah, for those in the Bible, he'll do it for you today. We have people right here on the line today that the devil, hallelujah, or the doctor pronounced sickness on their lives, but God has healed them completely. Hallelujah. God has redeemed them from the hand of the enemy. I came by to encourage somebody today. Don't be fooled by the situation, and don't listen to the fear factor that tells you that you are, hallelujah, in this thing by yourself. You are not in this by yourself. You have, hallelujah, brothers and sisters in Christ that you can depend on, that you can turn to, that will be a prayer partner for you and with you. I came by to encourage somebody today to tell them you're not in this thing alone. You serve a God, hallelujah, that has been through everything that you have been through. You don't believe me? Go to Hebrews 4, 15 and 16. And it tells us, for we do not have a high priest who is unable to empathize with us or empathize with our weaknesses. But we have a high priest, one who has been tempted in every way, just as we are tempted. He knows what we're going through. Yet he did not sin. Hallelujah. So the Bible tells us to let us approach God's throne, his throne of grace, with confidence, so that we might receive mercy and find grace in the hour of need. I want to encourage you in your hour of need, that there is a God that's waiting on you to turn to him and simply cry out, Lord, give me some help. Oh God, I give you glory. The greatest prayer ever prayed in God's word was two words prayed by the Apostle Peter when he was walking on the water and he began to sink. He simply said, Lord, help me. Oh God, I give you glory. Hallelujah. How many of us need God's help today? I came by to encourage you that you can endure this race. You can endure what you're going through right now. I just want to simply tell you, or encourage the one right now caught in this cycle cycle of temptation that's caught in defeat, hallelujah, that just keep going through the same motion over and over again. There's coming to your house today a way of escape. There's coming to your house today a way of deliverance. I came by to encourage somebody today that God will make a way for you. Here it is in our text today, and I'm going to get on out of your way. The Apostle Paul is writing to the church at Corinth. He's addressing some of the conditions that plagues the church at that particular time. Some of the conditions that plagued the church at that time is still plaguing the church today. Oh God, I give you glory. He deals with the centricity of Jesus and him being crucified. He brings about through his writing the clarity of the Holy Spirit and how he corrects men, human wisdom. Paul moves on, hallelujah. And I'm just starting at chapter number 1-4. Paul moves on. When he gets to chapter 4, he's dealing with the scandals that rock the Corinthian church. Oh God, I give you glory. He writes on. When he goes through 5, 6, and 7, by the time he gets to 7, he's talking about, hallelujah, marriage and the liberality of Christian living. Oh God, I give you praise. Paul works out, hallelujah, the human condition of being a believer here. Hallelujah, through chapters 1-9 of 1 Corinthians. So by the time we get to chapter 10, Paul has already established that we have liberty in Christ and that God will make a way for us. God will make a way for you. He deals with, hallelujah, all the things that are going on in the church. Paul here, during the time of the church of Corinth, he is actually in Ephesus when he is writing this book. Paul is writing to them because Corinthians, or the church at Corinth at the time, were dealing with all types of schisms and isms throughout the body of Christ. Corinth was a place where, hallelujah, they raised up an idol, or a temple to the priests of the goddess Aphrodite, or Venus, the god of sex. Oh God, I give you praise. And so the church was dealing with all of these types of things. Oh God, I give you praise. The church was dealing with all types of gods all over the place. So now that you have at the church of Corinth, hallelujah, you have Jews and Gentiles. You have, praise the name of our God, all manner of people. Because the town at Corinth, it was a melting pot, just like our churches are today. Oh God, I give you glory. And the people were dealing with all types of manner of religious isms and schisms. And they were offering idols, foods, praise the name of our God, and then turning around and eating the food that was offered up unto idols. And Paul deals with this, hallelujah, and he tells each and every one of them, hallelujah, you have liberty in God, but you must be careful about, hallelujah, how you deal with your liberty. You must be careful not to let your liberality cause your brothers and your sisters to fall. There are some of us that have been walking with God a long time, and we understand some more than others about scripture, and we know that we have liberty in Christ, but we must not allow our liberty to cause our brothers and sisters to fall. we must allow, we must not allow our liberties in Christ to cause our brothers and sisters not to be able to endure the trials and tests that they have to go through. Paul says it in the word of God that, hallelujah, he makes it clear to each and every one of us as he went through the scripture text. He says there's no temptation that has taken you, but it's common unto man. Oh God, I give you glory. What you're going through, God, hallelujah, he knows all about it. Oh God, I give you praise. But he makes one thing clear that I want to make clear to you. Hallelujah. You might be going through. You might be suffering now. But God is faithful. How many of us can yell? Or how many of us can raise our hands and say our God is faithful? He's been faithful even in the midst of what you're going through. He's been faithful even when you've been struggling. Oh God, I give you praise. How many of us have been struggling and not knew where the money was coming from to pay our bills? But when the end of the month came, we had just enough. Oh God, I give you praise. He stretched whatever we had. That's God being faithful. How many of us has been dealing with this thing or this man called Arthur? I'm talking about arthritis. But God has been faithful. Sometime we got up and couldn't even walk. But God has been faithful and he got us through. That's God being faithful. How many of us that just needed an encouraging word? We didn't know if we were going to make it. And at the very hour that we were ready to give up, somebody called us. Somebody ran into our path. Somebody just said, I was thinking about you. God placed you on my mind. Oh God, I give you praise. Sometimes that's God being faithful. Oh God, I give you glory. How many of us can just simply say that our God is faithful? That's what Paul was saying. He was saying we should not murmur and we should not, hallelujah, fuss and fight. He says unto us that no temptation has taken us that is not common to man, but God is faithful. I just seem to be stuck right there. God is faithful. He will make a way out of no way. He will make a way out of no way. This is the same God that make a way when my body was racked with pain. This is the same God we can call on, hallelujah, night or day. God is faithful. Oh God, I praise you. But he goes on to say, who will not suffer you to be tempted above all, hallelujah, that you are able. This is where we get the saying, God will not put on you more than you can bear. I came by to let you know that God will not suffer you above what you are able to be tempted. Can somebody give God praise because of his faithfulness towards us? He will not let us suffer, hallelujah, more than we can bear. The Apostle Paul, he is in Ephesus, writing to the church, because the church is going through hell and high water. The church is suffering all types of things. And God wanted it placed on record that he will make a way for them. You can endure what you're going through. You can make it through what you're suffering. You can do what God wants you to do. I want to leave a couple of things with you, and I promise you I'm out of your way. Hallelujah. When you have the ability to endure what you're going through, hallelujah, that ability lies in number one, you remembering your position in the body of Christ. You are positioned right where God wants you to be. You are right, Miss Sharon. He is a way maker. He is all that you need. He is, hallelujah, no matter what you're going through, your ability to endure lies in your remembering your position in the body of Christ. We are positioned so specifically in the body of Christ, and we need one another to make it through on day-to-day basis. I know that some of my brothers and sisters are suffering and going through, but God has called us out to make sure that we do our role in the body of Christ. Just remember that let this mind be in you, what was also in Christ Jesus. Oh God, think on those things which are above and not beneath. Hallelujah. What I'm telling you is start using your remembrance. Start using your testimony. If God brought you through one time, he'll get you through this time. I know that you're going through. I know that you're suffering. But God told me to tell you that you are perfectly positioned for your miracle. You are perfectly positioned for your breakthrough. Hallelujah. Your ability to endure lies in your position or your remembrance of your position in the body of Christ. The second thing, hallelujah, that you need to know is the ability to endure lies in your remembering who your provider is. The Bible tells us that God is faithful. Oh God, I give you glory. Hallelujah. He is faithful and just to forgive you of your sins. Hallelujah. The Bible tells us, hallelujah, that Jesus Christ himself, he sits on the throne to make intercession for you and I. And God sent me to tell you, he is faithful to your cause. If you don't believe me, go to Genesis when he promised Abraham, I'll make you a father of many nations. Oh God, I give you praise. And he did just what he said. Remember Daniel that was caught in the lion's den. Oh God, I give you glory. He remembered Daniel's prayers, and God became faithful unto him. Y'all remember David when he was running from Saul? I preached it a few weeks ago, how he was, how he had came to Ziklag and found his family taken. But our God is faithful and just to forgive us. And he redeemed, hallelujah, David's whole entire family. I came by to encourage somebody that God let you get through every trial and tribulation. up to this point, and he will do the same again for you. He is faithful. Oh God, I give you glory. Last point, and I'll get on out of your way. Your ability to endure every situation and every trial of life lies in your ability to remember his promises unto you. The first promise is found right here in verse number 13. With the temptation, he will always make a way of escape. There is a great escape coming. There is escape for you. Mama, believe me, you're going to have an escape. You got a great doctor's report on Friday. Your great escape is on the way. Oh God, I give you praise. Hallelujah. How many of us need God to step in and move on our behalf? Just remember what he promised you. God promised to be with you. Joshua 1 and 5. God promised that he would protect you. Psalms 91 and 2. God promised he would take care of all of your needs. Philippians 4 and 19. He promised he will never fail you. Joshua 21 and 45. God promised that he's always good. Psalms 119 and 68. The Bible tells us that you are good and you do good. Teach me your statutes. God is always good. No matter what we face, he is faithful and just. God is faithful. Hebrews 10 and 23. Let us with unswervering hope, hallelujah, profess that our God is faithful. Hallelujah. God is kind and compassionate. Isaiah 54 and 10. Though the mountain be shaken and the hills be removed, yet your unfailing love, all your merciful kindness for you and I, be not shaken, nor my covenant of peace be removed, says the Lord, who has compassion on you. God knows what you're going through. Hallelujah. And he will make a way for you. He will make a way for escape. I just want to encourage somebody today that if you allow God, he will make a way of escape for you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Saints of God, I'm going to get on off of here. I just want to leave you with this word today that you can endure what you're going through. And I came to announce that God is about to release, hallelujah, a space for you to escape. He's about to give you your great escape. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's about to give you your great escape. Oh, praise the name of our God. How do you know, Pastor Adams? I'll tell you how. He's shown you time and time again. Hallelujah. Just small examples. Hallelujah. He made your bills. Hallelujah. You made your bill every month. Hallelujah. Oh God, I give you glory. When you didn't have food in your refrigerator, he provided. Hallelujah. When you needed gas in your car, he showed up. Hallelujah. Small things. Hallelujah. So this thing that you might be facing right now that seems astronomical, oh God, I give you glory. He is ready, willing, and able to give you your great escape. Hallelujah. Can you receive it today in your spirit that God, hallelujah, has not only given you the ability to endure it, but he's about to let you escape from it in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Saints of God, I want you all to really understand this today. I really want you to really get this in your hearts today. Why, Pastor Adams? I'll tell you why. Because God is calling his people back to himself. Yes. Hallelujah. We're living in a fallen world. We are living in a time, praise the name of our God, where men are lovers of themselves and doing all type of manner of, hallelujah, sin. Hallelujah. And everything that's contrary to the will of God. God has called us out to call his people not only to repentance, but to restoration. God wants to restore those, hallelujah, that he has called to himself. I'm talking to the backslider right now. I'm talking to those that have tasted of God's grace and have turned their backs on him. God is calling you home today. Hallelujah. He is calling you, hallelujah, because you have endured, hallelujah, this thing, hallelujah, being separated from God long enough. He's given you the opportunity to come on home. He wants to restore you back to where you're supposed to be in him. Time is winding up, saints of God. Time is running short, praise the name of our God. And if you get nothing else from this message today, I want you to understand, hallelujah, that we have a short window. Hallelujah. God is telling, he speak, oh God, I hear you. We have a short window that we need to move in. Hallelujah. So anyone under the sound of my voice, turn to Jesus. Oh God, right now, because we have a short window. Hallelujah. You've endured it by yourself long enough. You've tried it by yourself long enough. You've complained about it. You grumble about it. You have, hallelujah, just don't know which way to turn enough by yourself. Now it is time to give it to Jesus. It is time to turn and say, Lord, I surrender all. Jesus. All to him I owe. All to Jesus I surrender all. And when we decide to do that, I guarantee you, based on the word that God is speaking to your hearts today, that he will provide a way of escape. The enemy wants you to believe, praise the name of our God, hallelujah, that you can't trust God. Hallelujah. And this is what I want you all to understand. When we talk about temptation, this is how temptation normally works. Hallelujah. We find ourselves enticed or tempted by something. Praise the name of our God. And then we find ourselves falling into that sin because we did not know how to, hallelujah, avoid it. And we find ourselves falling in that temptation or that sin. Then the enemy comes along. Here we go. Listen to me carefully. The enemy comes along and he tells you God will never redeem you. He tells you, hallelujah, that you can never make it back. He tells you, hallelujah, that you, because of that sin, you can never, hallelujah, return to God. Hallelujah. But I came by to tell you and put you, devil, on notice. The Bible calls you the tempter. The Bible calls you a liar. The Bible calls you, hallelujah, hallelujah, the one that accused the brethren before Christ day and night. I came by to tell you that that's how temptation normally works. But God is providing you a way of escape. He sent me here to tell you that he is binding the enemy right now to give you the opportunity to call on his name. The Bible says, in the day that you hear my voice, harden not your heart. And when you call on the name of the Lord, he said he will in no way despise you. He will come unto you and sup with you. Be encouraged today. You've endured it long enough. Hallelujah. Turn to God and turn to the great escape. Oh God, I give you glory. God, hallelujah, is calling his people back home. He's calling those that, hallelujah, that needs him back home. If you're listening under the sound of my voice today, no matter what you have done, no matter what you're going through, hallelujah, turn to Jesus now. Turn to him now and simply say to him, Lord Jesus Christ, Father, we thank you for your goodness and your kindness. Lord, we know that you are the redeemer of every man. Thank you for going to the cross for me. Thank you for saving me. Thank you, oh God, for letting me hear this word today. And thank you, God, that I know, oh God, even though I may have made a mistake and although I may have sinned against you, that you are my redeemer, that you have forgiven me, oh God. Hallelujah. I am a repentant soul right now before your throne, asking you to forgive me of my sins, God, asking you restore me, oh God, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, Lord. And I thank you today for doing this work in my heart and doing this work in my life. Lord, in the name of Jesus, thank you, oh God, for restoring me. Thank you, oh God, for keeping me. Thank you for, oh God, making a way of escape for me. In Jesus' mighty name, thank God. Amen. If you all prayed that prayer, hallelujah. If you prayed that prayer, hallelujah, and you need more information, hallelujah, about your walk with Christ, simply reach out to the ministry. You can inbox us here on Facebook. You can, if you're at Instagram, it's Pastor GAA. Hallelujah. You can send us a message and we can, hallelujah, work with you. We can send you materials, hallelujah, to help you with your walk with the Lord. If you, hallelujah, if you want to be baptized, as the word of the Lord says, the word of the Lord is clear. Hallelujah. We must be baptized, hallelujah, by the Spirit and by water. Praise the name of our God. So if you, hallelujah, want to be baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, reach out to the ministry. If you're in the Charlotte area, I promise you, I will personally come and baptize you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. If you are in surrounding cities and states, please just reach out to the ministry. I have pastor friends, praise the name of our God, all over the country that we can, hallelujah, connect you with, praise the name of our God, and you can be baptized and you can be connected to a church home, praise the name of our God. We thank God for each and every one of you in the name of the Lord. Please know that we are here to support you. We are here, hallelujah, to make sure, hallelujah, that you have what you need in Christ. So please do not, hallelujah, hesitate to reach out to the ministries. Praise the name, to the ministry, praise the name of our God, and we will help you in the name of the Lord. Now, Father, in your precious name, we thank you for your people. We thank you for the hearers of this word today. We thank you, oh God, that you, oh God, will show yourself strong and mighty in their lives. Father, they have been enduring for a long time, God, and you have given them the ability to endure. Oh God, we call back to their remembrance today, oh God, that you, oh God, in a mighty way, oh God, that you will help them, oh God, to remember their place in the body of Christ, that you would help them, oh God, to know without a shadow of a doubt, oh God, that, hallelujah, that you are, hallelujah, going to, that they can remember your promises that you have given them, oh God, and that, oh God, that you are the great provider and you are faithful to them. Father, we pray today, oh God, that you would touch bodies that's broken right now, that you would touch them, oh God, that are sick in their bodies, that you would make a way for your people, God, that you would heal up to the utmost, God, heal their hearts, their minds, their soul, their spirit, and even their bodies, God, in the name of Jesus. For those that's under the sound of my voice, oh God, that needs provision, oh God, I pray for them right now, oh God, that you would make a way for them, oh God, that you would provide everything needed, oh God, not just enough, God, but more than enough, that they might have enough, oh God, that they might be liberal, oh God, and give, oh God, and be a blessing to somebody else. Bless them so that they might be a blessing in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And those, oh God, I pray for those right now, oh God, that just don't know which way to turn, God. God, we call on you right now to manifest yourself, your presence to them right now. Oh God, touch them right now. We come against every, oh God, manner of mental illness right now. God, that you would help your people, oh God, that the enemy that's whispering in their ear, oh God, and give and have that spirit of fear on their life. God, that you would release them right now in the name of Jesus, that you would rebuke it, oh God, for our sake, oh God. And we give you praise, glory, and honor for it. In the mighty, matchless name, Lord Jesus Christ, we thank you, oh God. We praise you for it. In the name of Jesus, amen, amen, and amen. Amen. We thank God for each and every one of you again. We thank God for your time. We thank you for your being here. We don't take it lightly that you spend your Sunday morning with us I praise the name of our God. And you can always stay connected to the Restoration Church Ministries. Praise the name of our God. Sunday mornings, we have Sunday school at 10 a.m. We have morning worship at 11. Praise the name of our God. If you have a prayer request, please do not hesitate to put your prayer request in the chat, or you can inbox us. You can send a private message to Gerald Adams on Facebook or the Restoration Church Ministry. Send a private message. We take those prayer requests before the Lord in prayer. Praise the name of our God. Day and night, we take them before the Lord in prayer to pray over those needs of God. If you're on Instagram, you can send your message to Pastor GAA, and we will get those messages and send, and again, pray over those before the Lord. Or you can send an email to the church at restored@trcministries.org. That's restored@trcministries.org. We have prayer on Tuesday and Thursday evening, corporate prayer. But know that we are praying day and night over your prayer requests. So please send them to us. And we have, and I'm telling you, there are more things wrought by prayer than the world will ever know. We have seen prayer work. Praise the name of our God. We have seen God heal people's bodies. We have seen God make a way for those, hallelujah, that have been going through situations in life. We have seen God provide for those that need, hallelujah, provision. Praise the name of our God. So please don't take it lightly, hallelujah, that God answers prayer. He does, he does, he does. We have a Bible study on Wednesday at 7:30 p.m. You can join us. The information will be on Facebook that you can join us. And feel free to join us and be a part. Praise the name of our God. If you desire to be a part, please let us know in time. You can send me a message on Facebook, and I will send the lesson over to you that we'll be studying, and you can join us there on Wednesday evening. I thank God for each and every one of you. Please know my heart goes out to each and every one of you, and I thank you personally for you that sow and seed into this ministry, that we might do the will of God in this earth. We thank God for you. And if you desire to give a gift and be a blessing to the ministry, you can do so several ways. You can send a gift to The Restoration Church Ministries, P.O. Box 152, Indian Trail, North Carolina, 28079. That's P.O. Box 152, Indian Trail, North Carolina, 28079. Or you can give electronically, and you can give through Givelify. If you have that application on your phone, you can just look up The Restoration Church Ministries. You will see the logo of the church, which is behind me here, and you will see a picture of Lady Adams and myself, and you will know that you're giving in the right place. Or you can give through the church's Cash App, which is $TRC Ministry. That's $TRC Ministry. And I thank God for each and every one of you that give and blesses the ministry. I thank God for your giving and your liberality. But I thank God most of all for your being here with us and spending your Sunday with us. God bless you and keep you. This has been Pastor Gerald Adams with The Restoration Church Ministry. I want you all to go out today and enjoy this beautiful day that the Lord has made. God bless you. You're always welcome here at The Restoration Church Ministries, where the blood of Jesus covers every gray area of life. No matter what you're going through, God's blood covers that gray area of life. Until next time, again, Pastor Gerald Adams with The Restoration Church Ministry. Lady Adams is waving. Praise the name of our God. God bless you all and keep you all is my prayer. Heaven smile upon you. I love you with the love of the Lord, and there's nothing you can do about it. God bless you. Have a great day in Jesus' name.